Hey guys, welcome back to architutors. In this video we will learn about advanced modeling in Sketchup, or basically how to use different Sketchup plugins and extensions to design different building facades. And let's see how it can be done. So first of all, I'm going to get rid of this component, hit delete, and create an arc using the arc tool. Probably go to the top view. And continue this arc like this, and copy both of these curves. Use the move tool, hit the control key to actually make the copy. I'll copy this to the Z axis around here and right click on this and flip it along the red direction or the red axis. And now we have these two different curves on the origin. Select both of them and convert these into a surface, or basically loft them using the Curviloft tool. So click on this first option and it gives us all these different options the way it can be loft. Basically you can change the supplying method. And that also changes the number of faces or how they are added onto this surface. So I'll go with this one and click to apply. So this way we have this really smooth surface. You can click on view and click on hidden geometry to see all these curves or the polylines it's made of. And now what I want to do is basically make a copy of this. So select, use the move tool, hit control and make a copy on this green axis. And now let's assume that this surface is basically an envelope for our building and we can create any facade for this. And to apply it we can use some different extensions like Flowify tool. But to do that we need a planar surface with the same number of polygons. So that's why I copied it. And to convert this surface into a plane, you can use the Artisan extension. And in this extension, there's this tool called Make Planar. What it does is it basically creates a surface into a plane with the same number of polygons or polylines. So before we click on this tool, we need to go into this group, select all of these faces, and then click on this. And it gives us this option to basically select the plane. I'll go with the XZ plane since this is basically XZ and click OK. And you see all the number of polylines are conserved. Only the surface has turned into a plane. And keeping this surface as reference, you can create any sort of facade over this surface. I'll create basically a polygonal facade. So let's go ahead and click on polygon. I'll set it around here and also offset this by the offset tool and delete this middle face. Use push and pull tool to basically extrude. That's okay. And I'm going to move this hexagon inside these plane boundaries, because the same will be replicated on this curved surface. And let's make copy of this hexagon. Use the move tool, hit control and type 6 with a star and enter to make 6 copies. So you can delete this extra hexagon from here and these lines and select all of these and copy them. And same way, let's select all of these again to make multiple copies. And what I'll do from here is basically just create a line starting from here just a straight line. And let's hide this surface. Right click and click on hide. Also turn the hidden geometry off. Delete these middle faces. And use the push and pull tool to basically remove this geometry and delete this face. Do the same for the other surfaces. Okay, after we are done, unhide everything. So now we have all these hexagons. Let's select all of them at once and convert them into a group. Now to use the Flowify tool basically to add all these hexagons as facade onto this surface, we need to have linking edges. So let's create some lines starting from this surface, the planar surface, onto the endpoint of the curved surface, and same on the other side. And also select these two lines or the edges and convert them into a group. And now select these three groups, the planar surface, the curved surface, and the linking edges, and convert all of these three into a group. So that we are left with two groups, the first group and the second, the hexagon. And at last, what you want to do is basically select both of these groups, click on extensions, go to Flowify and choose the very last tool, Flowify without cut. Click on it, and what it does, it applies that hexagonal facade onto this curved surface. So if I just hide this group, you see it's sort of lofted the very same way as that of the curve. Let's unhide and let's also delete these extra components that we don't need now. And what I've done here is basically I changed the number of hexagons so we can actually feel this curve in this facade. You can do the same, even you can change the geometry. All you have to do is basically make that group. Like in here, I made this group with more number of hexagons and later used the Flowify tool to make this facade. Now to soften this geometry or basically turn it into high poly geometry, you can use two different extensions, Sub-D or Artisan. First you need to select the geometry, and having it selected, go on and click on the very first tool from this extension. And as you see, the number of polygons, or rather faces, in this geometry has now increased. You can go ahead and click on view and enable the hidden geometry so you can see this, and you see all these different faces in here that make this geometry. I'll disable the hidden geometry now, and you can experiment creating all different type of facades the very same way. So this is the way that you can actually create different facades and apply them on different curved surfaces using different extensions in SketchUp. So that's it for now. You can check out more SketchUp lessons from our playlist. And if you like this tutorial, make sure you click on the like button, subscribe to our channel, and hit the bell icon for all the latest videos and updates. Thank you.